done our work and our what we say labor system. You know, take example of any building. When building is being constructed, there needs a labors, right? And there needs a labor. Since there are labors, there should be supervisor. There should be a manager and the head as managers. So they are similarly, the exact thing is with the arts. They have the labors, they have the managers, they have the supervisors, workers, as we have. So they have also advanced communication system, because since we can see that they have meetings around together and they have such sophisticated and such complicated system of labors and all this, so we can understand this point that they must be having some what we say, sophisticated system of labor. And the Quran, and in the past, the Quran has told a situation that about Hazrat Sulaiman Islam, and I have shown you, I will give you later on, that in that verse, ants were talking to each other. That is what the description given in the glorious Quran. And there were some people actually, they took this book as a fairy tale. Just thought this is a book of stories in which such descriptions are mentioned. But in through today's research, this fact has become very clear that ants do communicate each other. They do talk to each other. And so, regarding this, the glorious Quran is very logical. So this is all about ants.
Excuse me, just say some words for motorcycle.
Well, motorcycles, as it is, it was first described by Sir Francis in 1597, and he said that the water is evaporated from the oceans, it goes up, make clouds, condense, and then it goes to the inland, anywhere it can go, and that the rainfall happens over there, and then it is again going through there. This is what described by the continuous process, and this is what described by the Sir Francis in 1597, in the end of 16th century. But the glorious Quran, I have quoted the verses, glorious Quran mentions and describing in great detail about the water cycling, that what about 1400 years ago, at what the scientists were able to do and sail around it. When he took a look around it, he was the first person who traveled around the earth for the very first time. So through traveling, he must be having some maps, he must be having some through stars. In the previous time, the people used to predict their direction through stars. So he must be having something with him through which he has proved this fact that the earth, that the shape of the earth is spherical and round. And it is of course not the flat one, because if it would be flat one, then there would be a sudden change. For example, see my hand, okay? This is my hand. For now, when the night will come and day will go, it will come like this and like that. So there will be a sudden change on this part and on sudden change on this part. But if you take it as this globe, it will go from this whole process, from this all distance. So there will be of course a gradual change, because the distance has increased. And through this distance, we can predict and we have proved that the shape of the earth is spherical. And the Quranic verses are giving more science, more scientific science, even those of science and scientists themselves. Thank you. Well, brother, there it was Sir Keith Moore, Dr. Keith Moore. Some group of Arab people, they went to Dr. Keith Moore in USA, and they showed the science and that is told in the glorious Quran and the sayings of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. They took this all regarding this the production of human being and in these scriptures, and they went to that Dr. Keith Moore. He was the leading doctor of in this embryology at that time. So Dr. Keith Moore said at that time, just 40 to 50 years ago, just in a few decades ago, he said that few of the statements of the glorious Quran and the sayings of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, are perfectly in the description, are perfectly true in the description in the light of science, but few are ambiguous. Ambiguous means these are, because he said that I don't know whether others are true or others are wrong, because the science have yet not discovered. And the science which have not discovered yet at that time, the glorious Quran was talking about this about 1400 years ago. So this is about embryology, and there are so much, and in Glorious Quran there is great detail. It has described this embryology process, the production of human being, and all this. And thank you. Well, ma'am, the orbit wall is changing. That's okay. The orbit can change. But I have used the word distance. Travel by the distance, whether in short orbit or whether in long orbit. That's no matter. But how much distance is it traveling? That is the matter. Whether, for example, that if there's a two road, there are two roads. One is going straight and one is going curved. But both are pointing, but both are in the same distance. Means one road which is straight, that is 10 kilometers, and what is which is when, and the other road which is curved, that is also 10 kilometers. We are concerned with that 10 kilometers distance. We are not concerned with the shape of the road, how and where it is going. So same the case is with the moon, that we are not concerned with the orbits. We are concerned that how much distance is it traveling in 1,000 years. And that is the distance I gave you, and I will show you later on in somewhere after. I will give you a copy of it. It is a whole equation, and I will that answer that you will be able to understand more. Thank you.